the pyramid of the robot.
Hello, I am using this wiki to tell you about something horrifying. I used to be an internet Comedy Central in 2015. My job was to view new episodes of South Park before they aired on TV. It wasn't until I quit my job because of something bad that happened. I will not tell you my name because I'm scared to blurt it out. When I turned 20, I needed some money. So I decided that I would work for a television company. And the place I went to was Comedy Central. One day, I was talking to the creators, Trey Parker and Matt Stone, about how the series was going. But they managed to tell me that they had a lost episode that they asked me to view it. So I said yes. They handed me the DVD and I inserted it. The DVD started slightly different. There was blood-covered text that said,
"Stay tuned for a special presentation."
Also, there was a dark, quiet voice reading the text. And I could barely see teeth behind the words. While staring at it, Matt Stone and Trey Parker came in claiming that something was possibly going to give me a seizure. I had no idea what they were talking about. We started watching it together. The Paramount feature presentation logo came on, but the quality was terrible and the audio was in G major. And significantly, the color was different. When it ended, there was dark red text saying, "I am God." After that, it showed a not normal version of the THX logo. As it zoomed in, Trey Parker told me to look away. He did not want me to look at it. After what seemed like 10 seconds, the South Park intro came on. It seemed like a normal episode but with some scary content in it. The episode started with Cartman, Stan, Kyle and Kenny talking about something during recess when Kyle looked at the sky. He saw what looked like a rocket flying into space. Kyle screamed,
"Oh God! I'm getting out of here!"
Cartman also watched the same thing. He warned everyone to find a shelter before they die. We sat there watching the whole playground while the sound of a nuclear siren played. After 2 minutes, the nuclear bomb hit South Park and the characters that appeared to be disintegrating were Sharon Marsh, Tweak, Chef, Mr. Garrison and Timmy. Then it cut to a scenery of South Park being burned down. The dead bodies of Cartman, Wendy, Stan, Kenny, Clyde, Randy and Heidi Turner were seen. It seemed that Kyle was the only survivor of the bomb attack. I could see that Kyle had a tear in his eye as if he was about to cry. I don't know if he was sad that his friends were dead and the city is blown up. Kyle went over to Cartman's house and what I saw scared the crap out of me. Cartman's mother was hanging on a noose with her eyes bulged out. Kyle went down to the basement and he was sitting at the table crying. I asked Matt Stone if he did the crying. But he had no memory of him doing the episode. He claimed he was at home when the episode was made but never aired on TV. Which meant someone hijacked the studio overnight and created it. After 3 minutes, Kyle stopped crying. He found a radio and turned it on. Not only did Kyle survive, but it looked like one of the news reporters were alive too. The man sounded like he was trying not to cry. The person on the radio said,
"Good evening everyone. Our TV signals are down. So we are using a radio. South Park has been badly damaged by a nuclear bomb. It appears to be people from North Korea who dropped the bomb to our city. This definitely could mean the end of South Park as we know it. More updates will come shortly."
Kyle put down the radio and walked away. The episode then cuts to the credits. It didn't play any music, it was dead silent. Trey Parker and Matt Stone let me go home early after what happened. Later that night, I was fast asleep until I heard my cell phone go off. Ugh. Who's calling me at this time of night? I asked myself. To my surprise, it was one of the creators, Trey Parker. He claimed that the person who made the episode was a man from Iran, which was later arrested for 10 counts of murder and serious nuclear issues. I told him that I quit my job because of serious everyday problems. He said that I can quit. To be honest, I do not have interest on South Park. I would have told you my name. But I just can't. To this day, I will never watch South Park again. You hear me? Again. Update. I took a look back at the DVD and on the opening, the thing that was flashing was a monster version of Barney the Dinosaur.